Welcome back to DBL. Lisa Martin followed all the COVID-19 rules, but she still got the virus, and she spent nearly 100 days in the hospital. I spoke with Lisa earlier about her incredible recovery in our special series, COVID Miracles. Lisa Martin, you're alive. I'm so happy to hear that. Welcome to DBL. So take me back, Lisa, to how it all started.
So in September, I called it, my husband brought it home from work. The day I went and got tested, my test was negative. But that night, I started a fever. Around the ninth day, my lungs just hurt so bad. I just called to my husband and I said, you've got to take me to the hospital because I'm going to die if you don't. I just felt that bad. And I ended up spending September, October, November, and December in the hospital.
Wow. Oh my gosh, that's so scary. Now, from this point, you have a ventilator put in. It's literally keeping you alive, and they put you in a medically induced coma. Do you remember being in the coma? Do you remember anything about it?
When I was in the coma, I did have horrible hallucinations, and they were so bad that when I woke up, I didn't care that I couldn't talk, that I couldn't speak, that I couldn't walk, that I'd had a stroke and half of my head was numb. I had several body parts that were numb, but I didn't care. I was so happy to be alive.
So the real miracle is that you woke up, but there's another miracle the day you woke up. Can you explain a little bit more about that?
On October the 20th, that's when my family got together to decide to take me off the machines or not, because I had a living will. They decided to leave me on 10 more days. I actually woke up on the 10th day, the day that, or just before that they were going to pull me off the machines. I was told that I had to have a double lung transplant. And last week, I had a follow-up, and my lungs are just fine. They actually used the words fantastic.
Mm-hmm. No, Lisa, this is incredible news. That is a miracle. What do you hope our viewers learn from this?
This virus is real, and it took me almost losing my life for certain people around me to take it seriously. And wearing your mask is protecting you and the life of another. So in my mind, it is selfish for people not to wear their masks.
You sound like an amazing person with an amazing rest of your life, and I want to thank you for sharing and being a testimony to what really happens in COVID. You're saving lives by doing this, Lisa, so thank you.
Thank you, and God bless you and everybody who is ill, and I hope that no one else catches COVID.
Amazing. We'll be right back.